From time to time, we come across scrolling text on various platforms like websites, mobile apps, and digital billboards. One of the most common examples is the stock ticker seen on websites dedicated to stock markets. In today's tutorial, we're going to replicate this effect using vanilla CSS. That's correct. We won't be relying on any JavaScript for this. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell if you haven't already to stay updated on our web development tutorials. All right, let's get started. Many of us may already be familiar with the marquee tag in HTML. In the early years of the internet, it was a common sight on websites, used to grab the attention of visitors. However, the marquee tag has since been deprecated and is no longer recommended for use. Instead, we can recreate the same effect using a modern approach, leveraging CSS animations. In our HTML, we're keeping things simple by using a heading tag to display the website logo, creating a minimalist version of the website header. Below that, we have a div with the CSS class, StockTicker, which will act as the container. Inside this div, each stock symbol is represented by an individual list item. Within each list item, we've structured the company name, stock price, and price change using separate span elements. This will allow us to style each component independently. Before diving into the CSS part, let's quickly add a few more stock symbols to our ticker. Here's what the bare-bones structure looks like. Now, let's move on to the CSS. We've already set up some foundational styles for the body tag and the page heading. Next, we'll focus on styling the stock ticker class, which we're using for the container of our ticker. First, we add font size, padding, and border for the container. The padding block is a logical property that affects the top and bottom padding. Similarly, border block defines the top and bottom borders. If you're interested in learning more about logical properties in CSS, be sure to check out our dedicated video where we explain everything in detail. Next, we have an unordered list wrapped around the group of stocks. Here, we are using the list style property to ensure that it doesn't display any bullet points alongside the stock items. Then converting it into a flex container is the easiest way to align everything in a row. Justify content with the value of space between will make sure that the available space is evenly distributed among list items while maintaining a minimum gap of 2 rem. We can test this by reducing the number of child elements of the UL tag. Noticed? Extra space gets distributed evenly. The align item center will keep everything vertically centered. Let's temporarily give it a background color so we can clearly see its boundaries. Now, we convert the parent div into a flex container and add the flex shrink property with the value of 0 to its children. This ensures that the width of the ULs can be extended if needed. Additionally, we set the minimum width to 100% to ensure it covers the entire area if there isn't enough content. Then, we add overflow hidden to the parent container to ensure that any overflowing content remains hidden when the text scrolls. Additionally, the user select none will disable highlighting and text selection, preventing any unintended user interaction with the ticker. Let's now work on some presentational styles. First, we apply the font weight to the company symbol and the price. Then, the margin inline is used to add some breathing space to both sides of the prices. This will ensure a balanced and visually appealing layout. Moving back to the HTML, we need two new CSS classes to identify whether the prices are moving upwards or downwards. Therefore, we add the plus class for upward movement and the minus class for downward movement to each of the list items accordingly. This will allow us to dynamically style the prices based on their movement direction. Following that, we utilize the before pseudo element to add an upward arrow for positive price variations and a downward arrow for negative price variations. This visual indicator will provide quick insight into the direction of price movement for each stock symbol. Next, we use red and green colors to visually indicate price movements. Red will represent a price decrease, while green will signify an increase. Now let's move on to the animation part. To initiate the scrolling effect of the ticker, we need a keyframe animation. In this case, we are using the transform property to move our UL element from right to left. This animation will run infinitely, with each iteration lasting for 20 seconds. However, there are two issues with this approach. First, it displays empty space at the end of each cycle, and second, the animation ends abruptly, resulting in a less polished appearance. Let's address these issues to ensure a smoother and more seamless scrolling experience. To convert the scrolling animation into an endless loop, we can employ a simple technique of duplicating the items. By keeping two identical copies of the content, we create the illusion of continuity as one set scrolls off the screen, seamlessly replaced by the duplicate set. Make sure to set ARIA Hidden True to hide any repeated content from screen readers. For clarity, let's temporarily add background colors to each of the lists to visualize the duplication. The initial list, highlighted in yellow, represents the original content, while the pink list serves as an exact duplicate. If you notice, as soon as the second list reaches the starting point, it abruptly gets replaced by the first element. The reason behind this sudden jump is the gap property we are using inside of the stock ticker. We need to consider the gap while transforming the position. To achieve a smoother transition between the two lists and precisely offset the end position in the animation, we can utilize the calc function to include the value of the gap. It's a good opportunity to utilize CSS variables for storing the value of the gap. It will keep our code organized and make it easier to update the gap property in the future. The final touch to our stock ticker is adding a hover effect. We can enhance the user experience by using the animation playstate property to pause the animation when the mouse hovers over the ticker. This simple change will allow users to interact with the ticker more easily. Let's remove the background colors, and we now have an endless loop of stock ticker with a smooth scrolling animation. The appearance of this infinite loop is achieved by animating the first child completely out of the container area while simultaneously pulling the duplicate copy all the way into view. This concept can be applied to create various types of endless scroll animations. However, it's important to note that overloading a page with multiple auto-scrolling areas can negatively impact performance. Therefore, it's essential to use such effects cautiously and sparingly to maintain optimal performance and user experience. Feel free to experiment with the code by following the link provided in the description. Share your suggestions or feedback in the comments below, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to stay updated on upcoming web development tutorials. Thanks for watching.